Thank you for giving us this opportunity. I'm Tharindu Mahapa. I'm an undergraduate from Faculty of Medicine and Allied Sciences, Rajarat University of Sri Lanka. So our study is on adverse outcomes of teenage pregnancies of Anuradhapura, Sri Lanka, a retrospective cohort study. So complications during pregnancy and childbirth have been identified as a major causes of death among teenage girls. But still, in Sri Lanka, a significant number of teenage pregnancies occur. This is especially true for the Anuradhapura region. So the objective of our study was to find out what are the adverse medical outcomes as well as social outcomes of teenage pregnancy. We conducted a retrospective cohort study on September of 2020. We recruited mothers who attended to the vaccination clinics of their children in three MOH areas of the Anuradhapura districts. 290 mothers were recruited. And out of them, mothers who had their first pregnancy below the age of 20 were identified as the exposed mothers, and mothers who had their first pregnancy above the age of 20 were identified as the non-exposed mothers. And then interviewer-administered questionnaire was given to them by trained interviewers. The result was analyzed applying statistical tests such as chi-squares test. In our results, out of 290 total mothers, 30% was teenage mothers, that is 88 mothers. And in significant outcomes we identified three major categories: the mental health outcomes, the medical outcomes, and the social outcomes. When we considered the mental health outcomes, suicidal ideation and suicidal attempts had a very high statistical significance. This is very important because the mental health of our future population matters. Also, if a maternal death occurs, it could affect the family devastatingly. Also, not wanting to have the baby was identified as another mental health issue. This is very significant because this could affect the care the baby received. In medical outcomes, missing the first antenatal clinic before 12 weeks of period of amenorrhea was found out to be significant. This is important because this could affect the care they receive from our services. Also, low birth weight was identified as an important medical outcome. And then, in social outcomes, most of these girls miss their educational opportunities. This was very bad for the society. And as non-significant outcomes, we identify mostly physical outcome, such as the pregnancy result, complications to the mother during the pregnancy, complication to the mother after the pregnancy, and complication to the neonate to be non-significant. This is surprising because when you think about teenage pregnancies, these are the factors that are more focused on and the attended to more. And the mental health and the education are not attended to that much. So in conclusion, there were considerable adverse social and mental outcomes of teenage pregnancies. Often these are less focused areas. Also, most of the physical outcomes had no significant difference between the two populations, according to our study. We suggest that preventive strategies should be applied in order to minimize the occurrence of teenage pregnancies. Also, authorities could focus more on the mental health of teenage mothers as well as their education in order to provide them with better care. Thank you.